Hey there, friends, it's Codiak here. Welcome back to Legacy Gaming and welcome to Elden Ring. As with pretty much everything Elden Ring related, there are some gameplay spoilers here, but nothing related to the main story, so watch on at your own risk. By now, many of you are starting your Elden Ring journey, and one of the first things you might run across is this Stonesword Fog Wall right after the tutorial area. Well, you know we like to punish ourselves here on the channel, and of course, Livid took it upon himself to get the necessary keys and explore beyond. Now, first thing you might be wondering, what are Stonesword keys? These are little items found in the world that you can use to unlock Stonesword Fog Walls, venturing beyond to whatever lurks behind. There are a number of these early on, and we've marked a few of them on the map so you can go off and pick them up yourselves if you're so inclined. I will warn you, this challenge is not for the faint of heart, and huge props to Livid because this was not simply open the wall, get a reward. Now, to be clear, it takes 2 Stonesword keys to open this fog wall. You can actually opt in to take Stonesword keys as a keepsake when creating your character, but realize that if you use both the keys you're given and you can't complete the challenge, that's it, and you'll need to locate more keys to unlock more walls within the game. What's lurking just beyond the wall is a gauntlet of sorts. First, you have to cross a room full of poison. This is simple enough: descend the ladder and beeline it across the room until you reach the stone platform. The poison buildup is quick and lethal, so make sure you're sprinting the entire time. For those of you that don't know, you can sprint by holding down the dodge button. Once you pass the poison zone, things get a bit more complicated. You'll be at the top of a series of ramps. The only way to get to the treasure below is by moving down the ramps to the very bottom. Of course, it's from software and this can't be easy, so you'll have to contend with a giant mechanical chariot of death patrolling up and down the ramp, keeping pace with your progression. You can use the cubbies on the side of the room for a quick breather, but just be warned, there are enemies lurking everywhere. Nothing fancy, but still a pain when in tight quarters. The real secret here is to keep moving. The chariot checkpoints at the landings of each ramp, so if you just get past that first choke point, just book it to the bottom. Because the patrol hasn't set its new checkpoint, you can really make great strides towards reaching the bottom if you just push it in one go. Obviously, this might not work depending on your skill and timing, at which point you might want to go from cubby to cubby. That's really up to you. It's a pain either way. Once you do reach the bottom, make sure to locate the Stake of Merica, because a load of enemies will most likely spawn and kill you. Nevertheless, you made it to the bottom and the real challenge. Once you clear the gauntlet of tricks and traps, you're met with arguably one of the most challenging encounters in the game, at least from what we've experienced so far, the ulcerated tree spirit. Think Abomination meets Rotten Tree meets Dragon, and you have a loose understanding of what this boss brings to the table. With movements like a snake, but the heft of a dragon, this is a challenging boss that most early game players will not, I repeat, not be prepared for. We'll be doing a full guide on this encounter in a separate video because right now, it's all about what's on the table in terms of loot. First is a golden seed, used to increase the number of charges your flasks get. This is great at any point in the game, but more potent early on when you're still struggling and still leveling up. The other reward here is a new summon, Banished Knight Oleg. Talk about an absolute unit, this thing costs a whopping 100 FP to summon, so if you're not a magic user, this is pretty much useless, but if you are, boy, you're in for a treat. If you manage to level up enough to use this summon, it will be a godsend as you tackle new challenges in the game. Armed with 2 swords, this is a tank and a DPSer all rolled into one, and he's up for grabs early on, if you're able to defeat the boss. Look, bottom line, there are valuable things on the table, but you have to weigh the options. This is a massive tease, used to trick players to come back and unlock the wall. Because it's accessible early on, it's easy, right? Wrong. Anyways, now you know what lurks beyond, and the choice is yours. Hopefully now you have a better understanding of what's beyond the first Stonesword Fog Wall. As always, our goal here at Legacy Gaming is to bring you guides that get straight to the point so you can get back to the action. And if you appreciate that, we'd appreciate your support. Hit that thumbs up and consider subscribing for more Elden Ring boss guides and more in your feeds. Of course, if you still have questions, you can join us on Discord. Our community just passed 20,000 members, and with a small section dedicated just for Elden Ring, there's always someone around to help out and answer questions. Check out the link below to join today. Finally, if you like everything we're doing here on the channel and you want to support us even more, you can do so by becoming a member. For just a couple bucks, you're helping Livid and I achieve our dreams of becoming full-time content creators. Check out the join button below to learn more. My name is Codiak, and from everyone here at Legacy Gaming, thanks for watching, and play on.